Ilka said we would meet, but I can hardly believe the great Eivor is fated to save my little Isle of Skye.
Who are you?
Ahead of yourself, as always, Edith. Eivor, Edith is an old friend and a seer. She contacted me for advice. Her people are plagued by nightmares to the point of madness.
I wasn't aware people settled on the Isle of Skye.
There are small settlements, but it is a place of passage for many, making it perfect for dreams to wreak havoc. Until now, I've mostly been deciphering if my cousin's feasting on feathers in her dreams means she should marry a farmer or a baker.
You lost me again.
Edith needs your help. And it's not just her people being affected. As someone deeply in tune with the spirit realm, I have also begun to lose sleep. I fear it may spread to our settlement soon.
I will investigate. But it is not as if I have experience chasing away bad dreams.
There is more. You're not going to like this, Eivor. But I believe somehow Ranvi is involved. Perhaps even responsible.
Valka, you've gone really mad this time. Ranvi would never do something like this. Nor could she. She's always here.
Ever since the nightmare started here, I began asking the spirits for clarity. And a vision came to me. Though it was cloudy, I know what I saw. You will find Ranvi amidst a scene of death on the Isle of Skye. The two of you will fight before you are forced to part ways forever.
That just can't be true.
Believing is your choice. The only way to find the truth and stop the nightmares from spreading is if you go to the Isle of Skye. I must tend to my duties, but Edith can take you when you are ready.
So, are you ready? My people can't go without sleep any longer.
I need some time before we head out. I'll come back when I'm ready.
Please, don't wait too long. My people need you. You're back. Are you ready to go to Skye now?
I'll find out what's plaguing your people. Whatever or whomever it may be.
here we are. The Isle of Skye. Beautiful, isn't it?
Any idea where I should go first?
Investigate Kilter Raglan first. It's where complaints of nightmares began. My hut is there too, if you need to find me.
Yeah! like a cheese there, huh?
Is everything all right? You seem...
Find the warrior woman with the braid. She is our undoing. Stealing our dreams.
A warrior with a braid? That can't be Randvi. Where is she?
At a church, northwest of town. That's all I saw in my dreams. Find her, and please, let me speak.
With a bird's eye view. No! An eagle's eye view.
Ach, Ulrich!
Georg, ein dürrer Wirsch.
Non è fede, mi muoio per me. Sono hungry e ci asua. Ah! Eine Beriebte.
it a bit strette, and show you something of Farinarse.
Feel stronger already. Edith, there you are.
Something you need?
I was considering going back to England.
Really? The nightmares are still plaguing my people.
You're right. I will stay and end these nightmares.
You, Dane, come closer.
What do you want?
You look to be a good fighter, but do you dare to face the greatest battle you will ever know?
Of what do you speak?
I speak of a terrible and monstrous incorporeal power whose name is feared across these lands. Fergal the Faceless, the most fearsome flighter in all of Grantbridgeshire.
Ooh.
Ooh. A flighter? Is that all?
Fergal the Faceless has silenced doubters before. Will you challenge him?
I will face the Faceless.
My God!
You are braver than most. Or, perhaps, more foolish. Come, I will give you a key. This key unlocks Fergal's lair, which you see now before you.
That is a house.
No, no. It is a den of nightmares. A pit of death from which few have ever escaped unharmed.
By words. Unharmed by words.
Go. Go now. And God be with you.
A new victim? What fool dares to challenge the might of Fergal the Faceless?
Eivor of the Raven Clan.
Eivor of the Raven Clan? My next meal. Are you prepared to be eviscerated with words?
I think I will survive.
I am Fergal the Faceless, and I am clever and strong. But you're not. You're ugly and weak, and you're a big smelly coward. You're probably too scared to even face me, now that I think about it.
Sorry, have you started?
Yes, obviously. I said you're probably too scared to face me.
It's the weakest attempt I have yet heard to disgrace me.
Ah, you think you can win with rhyme, do you? Well, if you like to rhyme, listen this time. I'm very brave. My flighting is grave. I'm not a knave, and it's victory that I really crave. Your tongue is fat. You're a sprat. You whine like a little brat, and we are in a spat.
All my life, I've not heard of a flighting so flat.
Oh, you've made a terrible mistake. Be ready for my finishing blow. I am the best at flighting. I have got powerful skills. I'm strong as an ox and clever as a fox. I'm sharp as a dozen hawks. Let me show you my skills, and then you I shall kill dead with my skill.
You can stop stumbling over your verses. I have already had more than my fill.
You... well... I... just one moment. I need to think. Give me time.
Fergal the Faceless, or Fergal the Wordless?
No! You get ready! The killing blow is... it's coming! It's...
Fergal? Hello?
Can I interest you in a game of Orlok?
I do miss the rattling of bone.
Orlok, a game of skill, Orlok. How about a game?
Let's do this then.
I am pretty good. Do not say I did not warn you.
Thank you. This will do. Interesting. Go easy on me, will you?
My game, stranger. Just give up.
This will do.
Sweet victory.
The gods favored your hand today. Shall we go again?
That is enough Orlok for now.
I sometimes think Redda makes these up each morning, just to keep us all busy. Come back any time, my friend!
Hello and welcome. Always good to pick up new stock for the shop.
else?
I must be on my way now. Goodbye.
I have an iron stomach and a powerful thirst.
Soma.
Eivor, my friend. It is good to see you again.
How's Grandebridge? It's gone through so many changes.
The city has bounced back quickly. The river brings trade, and trade brings prosperity. I have built this city into something separate from myself. As long as I protect it for the rest of my days, it will live on and on.
It was good to see you, Soma.
And you.
Thor himself could... Ah! A thirsty foe! Down it faster than me, and you are the victor! Got a wager in you! Put your silver on the barrel! Purse a bit light. No matter. Man your horn! I'll take on all comers!
Ruid's men tore through it.
Eivor, you made it. Dunwich.
It is time to light the brazier.
I'll light it. You do the talking.
Brother Valdis and I will scout the dock. Make sure there are no surprises.
Oswald and I will hold here until the brazier is lit.
The front gate is heavily guarded. You'll not be walking in.
I'll find my own way.
We'll be watching you back.
Dunwich. Now to clear out Ruud's men and light that brazier. Guards here are vigilant.
bless you.
Thank you.
Once the brazier is lit, the rest of Ruid's men should arrive.
Odin gives me a bargain. A few dead men at my feet in exchange for a ripe East Anglia, and my wife returned. What a day! You. I don't know you.
I am Eivor of the Raven Clan, the clan your men attacked before I fed them to the crows.
Who called for me? Was it you, Valdis, my love?
Why would I call you now, after 5 happy years away from your stinking balls?
I called you, Ruid.
You? Oswald, the hopeful king of East Anglia?
And Valdis's husband-to-be. Take your men and go. East Anglia is strong with Saxons and Danes united. It will not fall to raiders.
Must I set sail for Denmark with nothing to show for the journey, after coming all this way?
You'll have my weight in silver. And an abundance of livestock and grain.
I've taken 10 times that already. What's the real prize? I'll make you an offer, Pigfoot. A home gang, just you and me, for the future of your kingdom.
I accept. A fight to the death.
East Anglia's the prize. Let it be heard.
Hey.
The hazel is laid! The square is made.
When you see a chance, lead Valdis and the brothers to safety. They must not fight today. East Anglia needs them.
Let me be your champion.
No. He called on me.
Whenever you're ready, the king of sheep...
I'm ready!
Let's go.
Go!
Now! Run for the bridge! They're breaking off.
They've given up for now.
That puts some distance between us. We can rest a moment.
By Thor, he fought well. Raging like a bonfire.
We should go back.
Oswald may have survived. Ruud as well.
It's possible.
Ruud's men will press their advantage. We must be ready when they attack.
We'll go to Norwich. Meet me there when you can.
He died a hero. There's no doubt. If his god won't take him, Odin's sword women will. Elmenham will not recover. None of us will.
Seer, please. We'll die without blood meat. Your magic will save my farm and my family.
What troubles you, friend? Why won't the Seer answer your call?
I know not. But without her draughts, my family is doomed.
blood leading away from the house. Something's amiss.
I bear this pain with grace, Freya. But please, show me a sign. You have my thanks, kind one.
Your wounds are grave. Should you not rest in bed? I'll carry you home.
It is no wound, but the blood is mine. I made the potion, Freya's blessing, to help the crops grow.
Blood mead.
Good. You know of it. From my pain, life springs. Please, help me to the clearing. The field needs the blood mead.
There's a farmer at your house who needs it as well. She waits desperately for your return.
Oh, no. But my fields. If I fail in my task, the harvest is doomed. Please, bring me to the next bloodstone.
Seer.
The pain surges. But I must finish the ritual.
I could take her to the next bloodstone. She could finish the rite. Or I could bring her back to her house where the farmer waits. Here's the place. Are you strong enough to finish the ritual?
I am. Though I must rest. Then I will chant and sow the blood mead. A task I must perform alone.
I understand. What else can I do?
You've done enough, and for that I thank you. But return in a few days and see the ripening fields.
I shall. Farewell, Seer.
May the gods watch over you, kind one. Farewell. I call upon you, Freyr, blessed brother to Freya. I plead with you, O Vanir, leave a bounty where my blood mead falls.
No!
Gestre.
Skill at all, Og.
Ah, Orlok. I know this game well.
Aye, what say you? Let's go a few rounds.
Let's do this, then.
Very well, then. Let us start. This will do. Interesting.
This victory will be mine.
How did you do that? This will do. Thank you.
Almost got you now. Getting good at this.
My, my. It has been a while since I met a worthy opponent. Another round.
Another time, perhaps.
Another king lost Abel.
Stop washing your face with mead.
How can I face Halfdan Jarl now? I've failed him again.
We can take the battle to what remains of Ruud's clan before they hit back.
Easier said than done. His men are holed up in Bor Castle, a fortress on the sea.
On the sea? Then it must have a harbor.
It does. Guarded by a gate of hefty iron, held in place by timber spikes, difficult to force open.
Timber burns.
It does, but how do we reach it?
We rig your ship with oil at her front, and sail it ablaze at the gate.
They would see us coming, long before we reached the walls.
We raise a beard. An army of East Anglia's farmers. Throw them at the front gate as a distraction.
Saxons willing to die for a bunch of Danes? It's a stretch.
It can work, Finir. If they fight in Oswald's name, that is all the courage they will need. You there! Did you hear of Thane Oswald's fate?
Aye, we did. He dragged Ruud to the bowels of Elba, Dane devil.
Ruud may be gone, but his clan still plagues East Anglia. And would you join us to rid your kingdom of his dogs?
For Oswald? Aye, anything.
Two eager Saxons is not yet defeated. But you may be right. We may have a chance.
I can ride to Elmenham and muster what remains of Oswald's men there. But who else would join us?
The Reeve of Thaethford, Winston. He's a bitter old barnacle, but he would fight to the death for this land.
We can assemble a forward camp at the ruins north of Bor Castle.
Ride with me, Finir. Let's pay this Reeve a visit.
With any hope, Theovorth remains untouched by Ruud's violence.
Hope is a scarce word in this kingdom.
Maybe so, but I would rather hold on to something, anything, than ride with empty hands.
If Ruud's clan continues to roam this kingdom unchecked, the people of East Anglia will be as ravaged as these lands.
And where do we find ourselves? Riding into the fence to beg a horde of frightened farmers for aid?
To fight for a king that you gave them, Finir. Remember that.
Come back!
It was my task to find them a king, not protect that
Oswald
king.
Oswald wasn't crowned
danger
yet,
that
nor
might
was
be
he
bald.
Married. I say you have some work yet to do.
Right, right. No need to remind me how far I fell short.
Watch your back. Ruud's clan may still be nearby.
What did you expect, brother? Sword and silver? We had a bit of fun. That's what matters.
Ruud's men are a blight on this land.
Blight is too kind a word. A seer's curse. Theobald, just ahead.
Wood smoke and ash. Ruud's men have been here.
Did all this.
Ruud's clan is your enemy, not me. I come on behalf of the late Oswald of Ilmenham.
You're still a Dane from top to two. It's your meddling that led to Oswald's death, and even our kingdom for the worse.
Oswald was a friend and an ally, Reeve. He fought beside me, and I by him.
And look where that got him.
East Anglia will fall if Ruud's clan is not defeated. Fight with me to drive them off for Oswald and your kinsmen.
Pretty words, Dane, but the men of Theovard have their own battles to fight.
If you need an axe, I'm standing right here.
There's a village to the east, Kingsbury. It was taken by Ruud's men a fortnight ago. I'll not rest until it's back in our hands.
Let me and my raiders take the village. Save your strength, and join us for the fight to come.
A bold offer. If you do as you promise, the pikes of Theovard will be yours.
I will take this news to our forward camp, Eivor. Follow when you can.
I will see you there.
Kingsbury's church has a great horn atop its steeple. If you manage the task, blew it, I'll know you kept your word.
You ain't got the strength no more.
Stand tall.
The sinning that he felt around and hurt us, and he's fucking.
You called to me.
We heard you talking with the Reeve, and we wish to fight beside you. We owe Oswald for his good deeds and fair rule.
I'm glad to hear it. Go to the ruins north of Burg Castle. The army gathers there.
Thank you.
Take long.
Stay quick. Almost there.
Sound the horn and signal victory.
join me. Let's hope his promise holds.
The horn! It's been so long since I've heard that sweet sound!
Praise be!
Are you done?
I held to my oath, Reeve. I hope you will honor yours.
My promise holds, aye. Beovord will join you in the fight against Ruid's clan.
With your aid, we may yet save East Anglia.
In past times, that horn was used to muster feards all across our land. You may find others who have warmed to its call.
Good. Whatever willing men you find, rally them soon at the ruins north of Burt Castle. Theowar has answered the call. I should join Finia in our forward camp.
Sing, my rich.
Can't be sailing.
Can't raise the sail here.
No other man. Share a tale. Sing us a song. Let's hear a story.
You want a story, but I will give you a confession. And if you think me weaker for it, that tells more about you than me. Here is my secret. I love, love. I love being in love. I love the ache of love, the turmoil of love. My parents taught me that. To love, love. My mother once said, better to feel the stings and arrows of love than nothing at all. Be a bolt of lightning, not a stone.
Bring the
so many men forget to hunt. father would go by every hut in our village every night, mead and hugs. I would do the same. He always said, beyond the complex lives of gods are these simple truths. We forget, and it takes tragedy to get them back. He said this too. Hugs are hugs. Mead is mead. Love is love. Gods, I miss him. I see him sometimes, his face leaping from the waves.
We need an epic tale.
During my 19th winter, King Styrbjorn ordered the construction of a new longhouse. Splendid hall you now see at Thornburg. To build this longhouse, he employed the help of 20 men. I was among them, as was Hraði. Strongest and stoutest man I had ever seen. He set about felling trees and hewing wood for timber. Hraði was the fastest.
You salt skulls, got a story?
I often wonder, who deserves it? The largest cup of mead at the feast. Valka because she heals? The chosen dynasty of Styrbjörn's sons? Or Bragi who sits on a throne of his own here on this river steep? Should he get his ale before we all drink? Or do our lips all hit the mug at the same time? This brings to mind an old myth, no longer told. Of Olaf, the mead blood. His mead was too good, always to drink it. But none knew that his secret ingredient was a tiny dram of ox blood. But one day, he decided to feed a sip of mead to his favored ox. Yet the blood he used for that batch was his own. It is only fair, he said. But this angered the Jarl Thorgnar, who wanted the quaff of the mead before the generous animal. To avoid serving his own blood, Olaf served ordinary mead. But it was bland, and Thorgnar spit it to the floor. Olaf was ashamed. He left them, and never returned. Olaf's story died in those bland cups of mead. There is a hidden lesson here, of course. I will leave it to you to work it out for yourselves.
Dock the ship here.
That horn came from Elmland. Baldist must have gotten him.
The brothers' fleet, gathered and ready.